Hi guys, welcome back to Fragments of a Simple Life, where every video I make is super simple. Today I'm bringing you a soft-spoken magazine video. We have the newest issue of HGTV magazine. It actually looks really pretty on the cover, and has a little extra bonus. You flip it over, it says HGTV Property Brothers Bonus, Jonathan and Drew, everything you never knew about the bros, straight from them. We'll see if we have time tonight to get to this side, but first I want to start off with the actual magazine on the other side. For starters, on the front cover, it says 45 ways to do cozy, fab makeover, feast your eyes on page 29. This issue does seem to be kind of thinner than the rest, but let's take a look inside. This magazine always likes to start with the come on in page. Gives you a sample of a front door. Has a really, really beautiful color here. Called Vardo. It's like a turquoise green. It's really, really pretty. It says that this door is $600. And the brass nickel finish is $297. So basically, it's a very expensive door. And they finished it with a really cool welcome sign right here. Table of contents. It says tidy and childproof. A Dallas family pulls it off on page 80. Fun decorating. Copy the cozy big little ways to comfy up any space. This house could be yours. Love it. Go for it. Make our dining room look 10 years younger. And the high-low list. That's one of my favorites. Now, on this side, we just have the table of contents continued. Looks like we have a recipe on page 103 for some pumpkin pie with maple whipped cream, which sounds amazing right about now. Such a pretty color. We've seen this color together before in this magazine. This blueprint by Bear. To die for. It's the color of the year for 2019. I love it. I'm obsessed with it. There's just a little letter from the editor-in-chief. It says, don't spend hours browsing Thanksgiving tabletops on Pinterest. Do have fun mixing, not matching, placemats and napkins. That's a very good idea. It's funner that way, I think. It says, don't kick off any major home improvement projects. I think that's true because November and December you put out so much money for your family and your friends and holidays and food and gifts. It says don't reinvent your Thanksgiving menu. Stick with family favorites. crystal. I don't know that. It just says that in the magazine right there. I'm not that smart with plants. No green thumb. I try though. This says copy the cover. So it has samples of the pillows that were used. Pinks and soft grays. Black and white. The chandelier is here. The coffee mugs that are on the table and the bowl that's on the table. The chalkboard paint that was used in the background of the cover is by Benjamin Moore. We have the rug here. It's $250. It's actually not bad. And this is the chairs. $148 for a set of two. Wow, what color is that? Pink shades we love and how to use them. So here we have Denim by Sherman Williams. It's a really pretty shade of blue. It kind of looks like it has a purplish gray undertone to it. It's a very modern color. And they painted the brick of a fireplace as like an accent piece. It's really nice. India yellow. It's like a goldenrod shade, almost like a dark mustard. It's really pretty. I like it. It might be a little too dark for my taste. It almost looks like the color of honey, and at least it does in person, maybe not on camera. This is called Flame. This one's by Benjamin Moore too. Looks like they painted some sort of sink, probably in a bathroom. Yep, it says, a bold color in every room, including the master bathroom. So this is a bright orange yellow, or orange shade, that I guess they wanted to use in their bathroom. I'm not a fan. No offense. Dragon fruit. Nice pink color. It says a shade that's feisty enough to match her personality. Talking about the baby girl. That's cute. It's like a take on magenta, kind of. Then down here, we have a color by Sherman Williams called Dill. And it's a dark, I don't know if it's dark. It's like a medium green color. There's a hint of yellow in it. And it's warm and bright. It's pretty. It's too much green for my taste, but it's a pretty color. Now here's my favorite thing over here, the high-low list. I love seeing the dramatic difference in prices. $840 for this lamp. This one's a little bit smaller, but it's only $48, and it says a nearly identical pattern, but shorter in height. This cup is $91. $91 for one cup. This one's $16. Honestly, I wouldn't buy either one of these. You can literally make a cup like that for like $4. $1,200, $45. Yikes. Compared to $357. They're like the exact same chair. That's insane. So similar. Pillows. I'm not a big fan of orange, but this one is $104 versus $24, and here we go again. I've said this before, I personally prefer the cheaper stuff, and I think this pattern is cuter. Same with these plates, I like this one way more, and it's $75, and this one's $210. And these owls, I have these owls. It comes in a 3-piece set. This one's $23 for only one on Amazon, but I have like the exact same thing. Like the exact same thing, real brass. And I got three for like $20 at Target. It's literally the same thing and way cuter to me than that. Brass is so much prettier and like homier than the gold plating. There's more. I'll just go really quickly. I do actually like these ones better. That's probably the first time I ever said that I like the more expensive thing better, but I do like these better. I don't like either one of those. I like the cheaper blanket better at $37. And I don't like either one of those tables. Not for that price. Oh, there's the Property Brothers. They get an ad in the magazine, even though the other side is all about them. Oh, here's this article. Make our dining room look 10 years younger. A long-ignored room gets a desperately needed new life. So this is what it looked like before. You can tell it's been ignored. The carpet is not cute. The rug, not a big fan. Let's see what happens. Whoa, look at that. That's crazy. It says the color of the walls is called calico blue, but it looks really green, like on the camera and also in real life. The tables and chairs are really nice. They went with an oval shape for the table. It's contemporary and clean. I like the chairs. Very stylish. The mirrors in the background here are probably my favorite part. This is a nice piece too. Like this little banquet thing. I like that. Very pretty. Very different. Here's the room from the other side. They changed the lighting fixture. They added some really cool funky shades. Brought in a little bit of nature with a plant over here. A really cool modern rug. And then this little buffet. It's very pretty. It's very cool. Say it with art. Hang your feelings in a frame with one of these printed messages. Not all who wander are lost. $20 on Etsy. Let's stay home. Upcycled dictionary. $14. That's a cute idea. Okay. Let the sun shine in. Adventure. Be bold. Let my love open the door. That's cute. OMG. You are golden. Manhattan, love me, play the day away, the Smiths, this one's cute, Paris, London, New York, Roma, Barcelona, Toronto, and Tokyo. It makes me feel like I don't have enough art up in my house. Bonjour. Oh, happy day, that's cute. This must be the place. Oh, I like that. Hustle. Don't think twice, it's alright. It's my husband's favorite tea. He'll be so happy it's featured in a video. I'm not even joking. Copy the cozy, big and little ways to complete up any space. A cushy reading corner. I really want to do this. I'm waiting for my son to be a little bit older, and then I want to find a place in my house that can be a reading nook. Even if it's in the kitchen, because I do have like an actual nook in my kitchen. You'll see when I do part 3 of my house tour. But I want to do this, but I have to be careful with the kind of bookshelf that I use. Something short like this would work. I don't want my son to get hurt because he's 2 and crazy. But they have this cool deer figurine. I actually have one really similar to this for my Christmas decorations, and it's like velvety kind of, and it's bright pink and it's super tacky and I love it. You'll see, I'll do a Christmas decoration video, you guys. My decorations are not traditional. You'll probably get a kick out of them and think that I'm a weirdo because I go outside the boundaries of normal. There's no green and red in my house. As a matter of fact, I just bought a fake white tree. I'm not even kidding. But anyways, this pillow is amazing. I love it. Oh, sorry, I forgot, guys. This is called a cushy reading corner. I don't know if I said that already. The next one is called a warmed up living room. It says, golden earthy shades are pure warm perfection. Cinnamon colored sofa, gold toned side table from Target, bronze finished fireplace screen from Kirkland's. I love Kirkland's. Some really cool pillows here. I love this lighting. I saw this kind of lighting, this pendant lighting. It's old fashioned farmhouse. I was like, oh my gosh, I want that in every room. I love it. Love it. I'm obsessed with it. Stay a while breakfast nook. Oh, this is so cute. It's weird that the one thing that sticks out about the whole entire room to me is the fresh flowers. I'm kind of obsessed with fresh flowers thanks to my family visiting. My stepmother-in-law brought me fresh flowers, and then a friend of mine brought me fresh flowers, you guys. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, I have to treat myself to fresh flowers like every week now. Here's another one of those pendant lights. This one's an oversized water drop. That's very cool. And you can see right here, they actually come in different shapes and colors. This one's like a bluish, and then these two are green. I love it. Posh meets inviting bedroom. Sorry, guys. I try to wait and go through the magazine with you, but I should really go through it first just to pull those damn things out. So annoying. Anyways, posh meets invited living room, or bedroom, excuse me. They have both fur, velvet, linen pillows, which you can see over here. Faux fur and velvet and linen. They said it's A perfect retreat for the parents of three kids. Lots of textured elements. It's really pretty. It has gray cloth wallpaper, brown woven headboard. The headboard kind of throws me off about the whole entire room, to be honest. I feel like everything else goes, the cabinet, the pillows, the duvet, the gray, and the yellow, like it all matches and looks really, really pretty to me. And then bam, it's like a wicker headboard. I don't know, I think it's kind of weird. Maybe I'm wrong. Richly colored master bathroom. That's pretty. It says the not least bit subtle green. That is definitely true. That is bright like Christmas green. But it says it's a farmhouse vibe, and it definitely is with the choices of fixtures and also this lighting, this farmhouse lighting. I'm just obsessed. It has the rope. Do you see the rope? I love it. Oh my gosh. That makes me tolerate the green because the lighting was so cool. This house could be yours. Enter to win it. Go to HGTV.com to enter for a chance to win the HGTV Urban Oasis 2018. This is the exterior. Really, really cute. And this is the interior. Created by designer Brian Patrick Flynn. It's very relaxing. So much green. Am I missing the boat? Like, I really like my peacock blue, but it seems like this richer shade of green is really coming into style. I'm seeing it everywhere. Oh, look, more green. That's pretty though. That's more the tone that I like. Look at that. It's all the way up to the ceiling. I'm kind of obsessed. This room has my two favorite colors. It has the yellow accents too. The flowers and the window treatments. I'm gonna rip this out of this magazine and like make like a dream board or something for myself. How bad is it? Is it bad to never wash your kid's favorite stuffed animal? It says pretty bad. Too much germs. I don't even want to know. I'm terrified. How bad is it to not serve appetizers on Thanksgiving? Kind of bad. You could just not have company. That's what I'm doing this year. How bad is it to drive with a cracked windshield? Really bad, that's true. We went on a road trip across like 5 states and I had to get my window fixed because I got a crack in it and it was scary. How bad is it to let your dog sleep with his collar on? Really bad. It's very dangerous, especially dogs that sleep in crates. That's what it says. My dog does not sleep in a crate, though. How bad is it to hang on to a hot library book that's overdue? Not so bad. You'll get charged, but it's not that much. Look at the color of this couch. It's a little more modern for my taste, but it's absolutely beautiful. So nice. I'm obsessed. I love that color. It's just, it makes me so happy. "31 Ways to Kick Up the Character." This designer's home is packed with ideas that can take any space from from ordinary to whoa. That's cute. Look at all the stuff on her walls. I wonder if that's an actual hat or just a picture of a hat. I think it's an actual hat. She put a support beam, a little accent, some pendant lighting, some tile, almost like a bar backsplash. Black cabinetry with gold finishes. It looks like gold and silver finishes, actually. Faded vintage rug. That's pretty. This is cute too. But not having any cabinets on top is kind of weird to me. But if you don't need the space, then whatever. This is a pretty living room. It looks very, well, it's funny because I was going to say very comfy, very cozy. But that's what this whole issue of this magazine is about. These are very strange chairs. I don't know if I love them or if I don't like them. I do like that they're swivel chairs. That's fun. This table is really pretty. But I'm drawn to darker wood usually. Nice room. I like the pops of blue and this like burgundy, almost wine color. It's really pretty. This is a bathroom. Instead of a standard vanity, she put a sink in the top of a dresser. That's very different. That's very cool, actually. Here's another bedroom, and what looks to be like her office, another really cool rug, and acrylic chairs that I've seen these before. They look so uncomfortable. They look cool, but just so uncomfortable. I like the artwork on the back. It's pretty. This is just all the things that you can buy to copy her. You don't have to buy all of it, just to be inspired. Super stylish plus family friendly. This is a cute house. This is a children's library. I just really don't have that much space, but it's a cool idea. Family room. That's cute with the big oversized pillows and the shorter coffee table for extra seating. That's a big kitchen. That's cool though. Look at up here. It says that those are actually drawers. Each kid gets their own drawer. The den. It's cute. With a little tent in the corner. Lots of colors. This is a little girl's room. Look at her stuffed animals in a clear box. That's really a cute idea, I think. The master bedroom. Has like lots of neutrals, gray and cream, but then it has really cool splashes of color. It's cool. There's another little girl's room. cute, a little more grown up. Lots of purple. My daughter's favorite color too. This is how to get the look. Again, just for inspiration, not to copy. Tile's so nice, they used it twice. Spot it on the floor and then again in the backsplash. These fab Los Angeles kitchen dares to double up. So here it is, almost like a rug down here on the ground. And then you can see it back here. That's weird. It looks cool though. I'm just obsessed with this little nook here. It's so cute. I love it. I want to paint a wall in my house with a chalkboard paint. Like today. Mix, don't match. Placemats with napkins. So we have a tropical placemat here with like a checkerboard, almost plaid napkin. We have a petal flower placemat with a striped napkin. This is a denim placemat. It's like really made out of jeans. With an indigo like polka dotted napkin. And then we have a black and white placemat. And a napkin that looks like leaves. They're calling this a painterly placemat. It almost looks like someone's doodles. With a yellow napkin that has like fringe on the sides. This one is a striped placemat. Looks more woven with a floral napkin. A hexagon placemat, which is cute, with a polka dot napkin. Straw placemat. I've had these before. They're very difficult to clean. With a multi-hued napkin. We have a pink placemat here, kind of an interesting shape, and then you can't see probably here, let me pick it up. It's actually a really cute animal print. And then this one is a basket placemat with, it's called a block print napkin, a floral fan. This one's crazy. It's a spotted placemat with a plaid napkin. And then this one, I love, a botanical garden placemat with a triangle napkin. This one's probably my favorite. We have the pumpkin pie recipe. Those are cute measuring cups. I love a good hand mixer. I have a hand mixer that belonged to my mom. It's from like the 80s and it still works. 30 days of Thanksgiving giveaways. This paint index, all the paint colors that we saw in this magazine. And this is just ads. Happy Home finds that only look expensive. That's a cool rug. And that's it. See how it's upside down? We're now on to the Jonathan and Drew side of the magazine, guys. And I think, since it's kind of late, I'm going to leave Jonathan and Drew alone, and maybe I'll do a short video another day just to look at that part. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.